I am going to talk mostly about the adopted child, and particularly about the adopted child who also has the co-occurring disorder of addiction or addictive disorder. Adoptees are overrepresented in treatment. They are massively overrepresented, and we have to start thinking, why is that? There is no adoption, there's no relinquishment without trauma. You know, I don't want to get into any arguments about whether it should happen or shouldn't happen or any of that. It's about somebody entering a family that doesn't genetically fit with an impossible job description. The job description of having to be somebody that they can never actually be. For the adoptee, the issue of abandonment is life-threatening. Because if the first most significant person in your life gives you up, how do you know the next one isn't going to do just that? Everything we know about child development tells us that early trauma has an enormous impact on brain function, brain development, and on neurotransmitters. Like a plant that's trying to grow up around a stone, you know, actually it has to adapt, you know, the child has to adapt. So in a sense, you know what, we're talking about adaption, not adoption. We're talking about something that is associated with enormous amounts of grief for everybody involved. We're talking about adoptive families who often can't live without having a child. So we're talking about a trauma. We're talking about a trauma that can't be recalled but can be remembered. That repeats itself later in life. There is a compulsion to repeat. There is a whole sense for adoptees, which is why the sex and love addiction is so prevalent, particularly as an addiction amongst this population. Desperately trying, the hunger for attachment that has them acting against their best interests. So we have a trauma. We have a trauma that can't be remembered, that's played out, that's played out with anxiety and shame and fear and real catastrophic thinking that the next thing that goes wrong will be the end of the world. Not just this thing going wrong, but somehow, actually, I'm on the streets and everybody knows it's my fault and, you know, it's the end of the world. And we're talking about a trauma that by definition has no pre-trauma personality, so that the sufferer believes that actually the person they've adapted to become is actually who they are. And that's not the case. That is not the case. And I think what I want to suggest, I guess what I'm also saying, is that, you know, addiction and adoption will really go together, particularly as people are given up for substance misuse reasons, but also because if addiction is genetically proposed and environmentally disposed, you know, there is an enormous wound at the beginning of life. And I want to suggest that most people, I can't say all because I don't know all adoptees, but most people who have been relinquished will at some point need to see themselves as having a co-occurring disorder of both addiction and, I suggest, post-traumatic stress disorder. And I do not think it will be long until adoption or relinquishment is seen as, and will be put in the journals and will be seen as developmental PTSD.